Alright, this is English Muffin 28. Today I'm going to be doing an airsoft spray painting demo for you. This is just a little informational video for those of you that are thinking of starting to spray paint your guns. The gun we're going to be painting is the Sig Sauer P226. It's made by KWC. It's a cheap, clear springer, so it's a good beginner's project. You don't want to start out with your $600 Tokyo Marui and try and put a woodland camo on it and end up ruining the gun and hating yourself. So let's begin. Okay, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to get our materials ready. First off, you want to have an open workspace with not a lot of clutter. Then you're going to need painter's tape or masking tape. You're going to be using this to tape over the parts that you do not want to spray paint. You're going to need a primer. I use Krylon spray paint, but whatever brand works for you is fine. I'm going to be painting my gun black, so I'm choosing the black primer. Then I have the actual paint. It's flat black. And a clear final coat that will seal it and keep it the paint from scratching. Then you'll need some paint brushes for after you're done spraying to get into the corners and if you add any secondary colors. Having an X-Acto knife helps to cut off the tape into the corners. And a screwdriver if you're going to remove the already black parts that have screws with them. And newspaper to cover your workspace and the gun. Alright, the first thing we're going to do is we're just going to take some plain old tissues and we're going to give the gun a really good rub down. You want to get rid of all the particles and dust and hair that have collected up over the gun, because that will interfere once you actually begin painting the gun. So just take your time, get all the nook and crannies, disassemble it if you wish, and just grab all the spots that you're going to be painting. Alright, now we're going to be removing all the black parts that you can remove, such as the grip and the safety and the magazine, because you don't want to already spray paint over them. So take the magazine out, grab your screwdriver, and there are two screws on each side for the grip, so go ahead and take those out. Alright, after you've removed everything, the gun should look like this. Now there are lots of small and clear parts that have been taken out, so you want to make sure to keep those in a safe place or put them in a small bag so that you won't lose them while you're finishing the rest of the steps. Alright, now that you've cleared the gun of any black parts, you're going to want to begin taping the gun. Now, the idea for taping is to cover anything that you don't want to be spray painted. So, when I'm finished with the gun, I'm going to have a silver breech, so I'm going to be taping over that, and I'll probably be taping over the hammer and the trigger if I decide to paint those chrome as well. You also want to tape over the barrel so that no paint gets down the barrel, and then you're also going to be wanting to tape over any holes that lead into the gun and would let the paint interfere with the actual workings of the gun. So let's begin. Alright, after you're done painting, your gun should look like this. We have the barrel covered, this assembly pin, safety housing. We have a little spot over the hammer so that won't get spray painted and get stuck. And then the magazine we've just spray painted the bottom, which is black. Now you're ready to begin the painting process. Okay, now that the taping's done, we've moved out to my garage, and we can begin the painting process. I rigged up this little hanger and just looped it through the trigger guard, and that allows me to hit all the angles instead of having to spray one sideways and then flip it over. So first we'll start with the Krylon Black Primer. Remember to use slow, sweeping motions. Hold it about 6 inches away and don't really coat it, just do fine mist back and forth. You can take as much time as you want and as many coats as you like. Okay, I've let the primer sit and dry for about 30 minutes. Now we're gonna put on the flat black coat. Okay, now that I've let the primer and base coat dry, I can remove the tape on the breech, take my bottle of Krylon chrome paint and a brush and manually apply it. Then after that dries, we can seal it. Now that we've let the chrome layer on the breech clear, we're ready to begin our final coat. It's the flat clear finish by Krylon. Okay, we've let the finishing coat dry. Now all we have to do is take off the tape that's left on the gun and reassemble the gun, and then we'll have our finished product. Alright, I've reassembled the gun, put the grips back on, put the safety mechanism back in, and now we have the finished product. I hope this video was informational for you. And I hope you'll have as much fun painting your guns as I've had mine. Thanks for joining me.